Today we are reading from Srimad Bhagavatam, Canto 5, Chapter 18, Text Number 4. The topic is, the residents of Jambudvipa offer prayers. Vadanti Vishvam Kavayosmanasvaram Pashyanti Cha Adhyatma Vido Vipaschita Tatapi Mukhyanti Tava Ajamayaya Suvismitam Krityam Ajam Natosmitam Vadanti Vispam Kavayosmanasparam Pashyanti Cha Adhyatma Vito Vipaschita Tatapi Mukhyanti Tava Ajanimayaya Suvismitam Krityam Ajam Natosmitam Vadanti Vishvam Kavayasmanasvaram Pashyanti Cha Adhyatma Vito Vipaschita Tatapi Mukhyanti Tava Ajamayaya Suvismitam Krityam Ajam Natosmitam. Vadanti Vishvam Kavayo Nusasparam Pashyanti Chatyatma Vito Vipaschita Tadapi Mukhyanti Tava Ajamayaya Suvismitam Krityam Ajam Natosmitam. Vadanti Vishvam Kavayosmanasvaram Pashyanti Cha Atma Vitna Vidopyashitya Tatapi Mukhyanti Tava Ajamayaya Suvismitam Krityam Ajam Natosmitam. Vadanti Vishvam Kavayosmanasvaram Pashyanti Cha Atma Vito Vipaschita Tatapi Mukhyanti Tava Ajamayaya Suvismitam Krityam Ajam Natosmitam. Matajis, Vadanti Vishvam Kavayosmanasvaram Pashyanti Cha Atma Vito Vipaschita Tatapi Mukhyanti Tava Ajamayaya Suvismitam Krityam Ajam Natosmitam. Vadanti Vishvam Kavayosmanasvaram Pashyanti Cha Atma Vito Vipaschita Tatapi Mukhyanti Tava Ajamayaya Suvismitam Krityam Ajotna Tasmiham. Word to word translation. Vadanti, they say authoritatively. Vishvam, the entire material creation. Kavaya, great learned sages. Sma, certainly. Nasvaram, perishable. Nasvaram, perishable. Pashyanti, they say in trance. They see in trance. Cha, also. Adhyatma Vida, who have realized spiritual knowledge. Vipaschita, very learned scholars. Tatapi, still. Mukhyanti, become illusioned. Tava, your. Aja, O unborn one. Mayaya, by the illusory energy, suvismitam, most wonderful, krityam, activity, ajam, unto the Supreme Unborn One, natasmi, I offer my obeisances, tam, unto him. Translation and purport by Jagat Guru Sri Prabhupada, Prabhupada ki jai. O Unborn One, learned Vedic scholars who are advanced in spiritual knowledge certainly know that this material world is perishable, as do other logicians and philosophers. In trance, they realize the factual position of this world and they preach the truth as well. Yet, even they are sometimes bewildered by your illusory energy. This is your own wonderful pastime. Therefore, I can understand that your illusory energy is very wonderful, and I offer my respectful obeisances unto you. Purport. Not only does the illusory energy of the Supreme Personality of Godhead act on the conditioned soul within this material world, but sometimes it also acts on the most advanced learners as scholars who factually know the constitutional position of this material world through realization. As soon as someone thinks, I am this material body, aham mameti, and everything in relationship with this material body is mine, he is in illusion. This illusion caused by the material energy acts especially on the conditioned souls, but it sometimes also acts on liberated souls as well. A liberated soul is a person who has sufficient knowledge of this material world and is therefore unattached to the bodily conception of life. But because of association with the modes of material nature for a very long time, even liberated souls sometimes become captivated by the illusory energy due to inattentiveness in the transcendental position. Therefore, Lord Krishna says in Bhagavad Gita, Mam eva prapantante mayam etam tarantite. Only those who surrender unto me can overcome the influence of the material energy. Therefore, no one should think of himself as a liberated person immune to the influence of Maya. Everyone should very cautiously execute devotional service by rigidly following regulative principles. Thus, he will remain fixed at the lotus feet of the Lord. Otherwise, a little inattention will create havoc. We have already seen an example of this case, this in the case of Maharaj Bharata. Maharaj Bharata was undoubtedly a great devotee, but he turned his attention slightly toward a small deer. He had to suffer two more births, one as a deer and another as a Brahmana Jadabrata. Afterwards, he was liberated and went back home to Godhead. The Lord is always prepared to excuse his devotee, but if a devotee takes advantage of the Lord's leniency and purposefully commits mistakes again and again, the Lord will certainly punish him by letting him fall down into the clutches of the illusory energy. In other words, theoretical knowledge acquired by studying Veda is insufficient to protect one from the clutches of Maya. One must strongly adhere to the lotus feet of the Lord in devotional service. Then one position is secure. ஓம் அஜானத்தி மிரந்தஸ கணாஞ்சன சலாக்கயா சக்ஷுரோன்மிலிதம் யேன தஸ்மை ஸ்ரீ குருவே நமஹ. ஸ்ரீ சைதன்ய மனோபிஸ்தம் ஸ்தாபிதம் யேன பூதலே ஸ்வயம் ரூப கதா மஹ்யம் ததாதி ஸ்வ பதாந்திஹம். வந்தேஹம் ஸ்ரீ குரும் ஸ்ரீயுத பத கமலம் ஸ்ரீ குரு வைஷ்ணவாம் ச ஸ்ரீரூபம் சாகர்ஜாதம் சககன ரகுநாதாந்விதம் தம் சஜீவம் சாத்வைதம் சாவதூதம் பரிஜன சகிதம் கிருஷ்ண சைத்தன்ய தேவம் ஸ்ரீரதா கிருஷ்ணபாதான் சகனலிதா ஸ்ரீ விஷாகாவிதம் ச நமவோம் விஷ்ணுபதாய கிருஷ்ணப்ரஷ்டாய பூதலே ஸ்ரீமதே பக்தி வேதாந்த சுவாமி திநாமினே நமஸ்தே சாரஸ்வத் தேவே கௌரவாணி பிரச்சாரிணே நிர்விசேஷ சூன்யவாதி பாஷ்யத்ய தேசதாரிணே வாஞ்சாகல்பதுரூபஸ்ய கிருபா சிந்தூபேவ ச பதிதானாம் பாவனேப்யோ வைஷ்ணவேப்யோ நமோ நமஹ. ஓம் நமோ மகாவதன்யாய கிருஷ்ண பிரேம பிரதாயதே கிருஷ்ணாய கிருஷ்ண சைத்தன்ய நாம்னே கௌரத்ரிஷபே நமஹ. ஸ்ரீ கிருஷ்ண சைத்தன்ய பிரபு நித்யானந்த ஸ்ரீ அத்வைத கதாதர ஸ்ரீவாசாதி கௌரபக்தவந்த. ஹரே கிருஷ்ண 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 ஹரி ஹரே, ஹரே ராம ஹரே ராம 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 ஹரே ஹரே. ஹரே கிருஷ்ண. வெல்கம் டு திஸ் மார்னிங் ஸ்ரீமத் பாகவதம் செஷன். வெரி ஐ லுக்கிங் அட் த வெரி என்கரேஜிங் இன்ஸ்பைரிங் டிவோட்டிஸ். ஐ ஃபீல் அவுட் ஆஃப் பிளேஸ் டு பி சிட்டிங் ஹியர் to speak on this very wonderful pulpit by Srila Prabhupada. I'm not a regular speaker. Sometimes I get into this difficulty when somebody asks. I take courage to sit on this Vyasyasana, try to speak something. So you all empower me so that I can do some justification for the expectations. Before we start, let us take few lines about the glories of Srimad Bhagavatam, because Bhagavatam is not different from Krishna, and by Prabhupada's mercy we have this available and accessible to us. Such few lines from various quotations from the Srimad Bhagavatam itself, 12th canto 13th chapter 11, verse number 11 and 12. This Bhagavatam is the essence of all Vedanta philosophy, because its subject matter is the absolute truth, which, while non-different from the spirit soul, is the ultimate reality, one without a second. The goal of this literature, the goal of this Srimad Bhagavatam, is exclusive devotional service unto the supreme truth. The significance of any item or person can be fully comprehended if one understands its glories. The same is true for such a transcendental literature, Srimad Bhagavatam. According to Sri Vishnu Chakravarti Thakur, Srimad Bhagavatam can be compared to a lamp, the sun, Mohini Murti, a desert tree and a tasty fruit. It is compared to a lamp because, just as a lamp dissipates darkness in a room, the lamp of Bhagavatam eradicates the darkness of ignorance and reveals the general description of the Lord, such as his creation, pastimes and dealings with the material world. The sun analogy is used to further elucidate the capability of Bhagavatam in totally nullifying the effects of ignorance, just as the rising sun disperses the dense darkness of night and along with it all mischievous, envious beings. Specifically though it describes how this Purana, another from the sun, has now risen in Kali Yuga for those who have lost their knowledge. Mohini Murti distributed the nectar to the demigods while baffling the demons by charms. The similar way, Bhagavatam baffles those who approach it insincerely by giving out deviant meanings. So it goes on like this. So Srimad Bhagavatam is a very instructive literature for us. And by Prabhupada's mercy, we are able to get just just a tiny portion of it to our application in our life. I heard in one of the lectures, Prabhupada, when he used to translate, the speed used to be regularly, particular speed will be the translation speed. But sometimes the speed is reduced, he will take little extra time or little more time than normal wait. So one time the disciples asked Prabhupada, Prabhupada, why this is, you are taking some time too long to write some purports. So Prabhupada replied, see, first of all, Bhagavatam is in Sanskrit, which is a very, the language which bewilders many highly learned scholars also. That, from that language, I had to translate it to English, which is a foreign language, where it has got limitations of expressing views and, you know, the feelings. That too, to make it in such a way that you can relate to that, all of you can relate to that, digest it, accept it in your life and preach to others. So that much of consideration he had taken to put on the purports, his purports. Today's purport, very, many times all the purports are very, very instructive, but today's purport, very, it's like a jewel, lot of instruction Prabhupada brought out in this. If you look at it, Prabhupada says, there are many instructions coming out of this purport, but few things I picked up, like illusory energy act on most advanced learned souls also, one. Second, no one should consider himself liberated person immune to the influence of Maya. Very strong. No one should consider himself liberated person immune to the influence of Maya. Third, again very instructive, due to inattentiveness, even liberated souls sometimes captivated by illusory energy. So what to speak of us? Due to inattentiveness, even liberated souls sometimes captivated by illusory energy. Again, further he says, execute devotional service very cautiously by rigidly following regulative principle. Execute devotional service very cautiously by rigidly following regulative principles. Again, two more very profound and informative. Lord is always prepared to excuse his devotees, but if a devotee takes advantage of his leniency and purposely commits mistakes again and again, he will fall down to clutches of illusion energy. To concluding the whole purport, Prabhupada gives very strong message where he says, theoretical knowledge acquired by studying the Vedas is insufficient to protect one from the clutches of Maya. Theoretical knowledge acquired by studying the Vedas is insufficient to protect one from the clutches of Maya. One must strongly adhere to the lotus feet of the Lord in devotional service. Then one position is secure. Such a wonderful purport for today, where in the Jambudvipa, the king, Bhadrasrava, is offering prayers with his intimate assistants. So if you read the translation, O Anban one, learned Vedic scholars who are advanced in spiritual knowledge certainly know that this material world is perishable, as do other logicians and philosophers. In trance, they realize the actual position of this world and they preach the truth as well. Yet, even they are sometimes bewildered by illusory energy. This is your own wonderful pastime. Therefore, I can understand that your illusion is wonderful and I offer my respects and unto you. So here, the some of the few wordings in this purport, if you try to give more analysis, more analysis relate to it in a very close way, maybe it will be useful in our sadhana, in our life of practice. Prabhupada says, inattentiveness even liberated souls. This is very, this one particular word, inattentiveness, is a natural thing for most of us. Every day when we chant the 10 offenses, the last one we say, though it is not listed the 10, it's 11th one, where it says inattentive chanting, that means not attentive what you are doing. Similarly, we can be inattentive in many aspects of a devotional service by mechanical way. Many times initially when you start very enthusiastically, very carefully, very attentively, we recite many of the prayers, right from offering obeisance to spiritual master. Now most of the, when you come before Prabhupada deities, we offer pranam mantra, but over the period it become more mechanized. We keep on chanting the sentences and verses, but mind is moving here and there. Similarly, when you chant our maha mantras, we are having the bead bag in our hand, but the mind is wandering here and there. Many times, many scholar people also keep telling, pull back the mind, pull it back. So inattentiveness is a root cause for many of our struggles in spiritual life. The more we are attentive, more the progress can be steady and rapid. Because what we got, the devotional service, is very easily we got this. We didn't go to any forest doing tapasya for hundreds of thousands of years by following very rigid austerities. But by some Vaishnava mercy, but some of Prabhupada's followers, other Vaishnavas, somehow we got introduction to the process. Somebody further encouraged us to continue in the process. So since we don't do much endeavor, since we got it very easily, we fail to appreciate the value of it. It's always said, supposing a person who's employed, who's done engineering, he studies roughly about 15-20 years to get the degree. That too in the last 5 years, when he really do the professional course, he spends hours together like a madman, forgetting everything, night, sleep, everything. And after that, he goes to employment to get few thousands of rupees for a post, for a position, for appreciation. So much endeavor, and also while you are serving, while you are employed, you have to spend lot of time, energy to maintain the knowledge what you acquired, to maintain the post, maintain the recognition, appreciation. For a small, insignificant material benefit, so much endeavor is required. But when it comes to something which is beyond our comprehension, which is beyond our comparison, to get such a spiritual benefit, the amount of effort, energy we should put, that if you make some deep introspection on a daily basis, how sincere we have been trying to apply whatever we are reading in your practical life. More we do that touch of introspection analysis, that should be honest analysis. If we do that, then we will understand where we are failing, where we are lacking, where we are inattentive. As Prabhupada says, finally, theoretical knowledge we have been hearing every day. We sit for 1 hour, attend to the class, but we are sitting in the class, but when the class gets over after maybe 1 hour, when you go out, hardly two or three sentences remains in our consciousness. Even out of that also few words remains in our listening. That's what, see, like Sravanam is complete by hearing, meditating what we heard and applying it on our regular sadhana. That's how, of course, even then, even 1 hour, two sentences, two words, but if you are able to meditate repeatedly and try to apply in our regular sadhana, it gives a lot of impetus to be more attentive, more meditation take place, and we become serious in our sadhana also. Unless this is done, whatever we do, it remains superficial, very external. If you don't internalize what we hear, because normally before sitting the class also, we look at who is the speaker, we make opinion about that person, whether, you know, what he is going to say. So before really sitting in the class, we make too many calculation, judgment before really sitting in the class. And according to our relationship with the speaker, we are attentive or inattentive, both happens. But whatever that, the message is coming from Bhagavatam. So if you are, like, you know, even as Prabhupada says, the taking it for granted that he is immune from Maya, malicious energy, like we, it starts in a small way. We are, most of the our struggles are degradation in the spiritual life, it happens because it starts a small negligence. We make a small, okay, one day, what's the big deal? It starts a small negligence. But the small thing makes a foundation for becoming more and more inattentive. So with all these setbacks, if you look at in our own surroundings, you can see many devotees who have been making rapid progress, they are very serious, but we feel that we are lacking behind something. Why? That could be because that we are not paying enough attention to the process which we have taken. There could be many reasons for distractions. But, and as today I said, every day, I heard from some senior devotees, every day before we go to the bed, for 10-15 minutes, sit peacefully, keep aside everything, including our mobile also, keep aside everything, do introspection throughout the day, morning till evening, what was our sincerity to the process, how much we became sincere in chanting on rounds, and while we are sitting, standing in the kirtan also, the kirtan sound is coming, but body is there, but mind is miles and miles away, looking for some unfinished service or something which is not connected. We are there in the kirtan physically, but mentally we are not there. If you do analysis like that, similarly, in our relationship with the devotees, in doing our service, and also how much we've been careful not to commit any offenses. Because many times over the period, since we all stayed together, we take it for granted, slowly, as we say, the familiarity breeds contumption. So we slowly start treating more and more offensive to our own other practicing devotees. Because that is our nature. As Prabhupada says, having been living in the material world, under the modes of material nature, for many millions and millions of lifetime, this has become our nature. So the more you try to do on a daily basis, because the more we try to do this, we get help from our Paramatma, inner consciousness, which wants us every day, every time, you are getting directions, instructions for to become sincere. But how much we are receptive to the direction, That makes a difference. We may be hearing, but many times we ignore. Supposing somebody does something wrong, that immediately they are about to do something wrong also, which is not conducive, which is not helpful to Krishna consciousness. There will be a warning coming in your mind. It will say, no, please don't do that, don't do that. But still, we ignore and we end up doing which is totally non-favorable to our Krishna conscious practice. So like that, if you do on a daily basis, understand and try to rectify. Because certain times, many times, we know we are wrong. When you know that, immediate our reaction could be, mostly we try to justify what we are doing. We don't try to correct ourselves, but we try to justify. I am not the only one. There are many people doing like this. It's not a lifetime job. It could be many lifetimes. Like, you know, we have a lot of justification to just do whatever we've been doing. But instead of that, if we try to correct ourselves in our endeavors, then you get the support from the process, the power of the process is, you will be able to grasp in the more outside, in the very sufficient, substantial quantity to move forward. And as we say that, as long as we are under the modes of nature, the challenges are going to be there. Day in, out, every day we are going to face these type of challenges. And every minute, padam padam vipadam. And our life is full of life of dependence only. But still, due to the false ego, we always think that we are independent. Every day to get up in the morning, all depends on if you have good health. If you want to take bath, there must be water in the tap. Somebody must have done it for you. If you want to brush your teeth also, you must have toothpaste, whatever it may be. If you want to go take prasadam, somebody should have cooked it for you. Somebody should serve it to you. Like that, each and every minute, every second of our life is depending on somebody or some agency of Krishna only. So such is the state where we can say that we are doing. How we can say that we are doing? Where is it? Where we are free? Even now, supposing I am sitting here trying to speak on this particular purport. See, in our mind, in this lifetime itself, maybe I am 62 now, so many things have been acquired and stored in our memory. But to speak on a particular topic in a very, to maintain the flow, to speak cohesively, it is not our plan, it is not our endeavor. It happened by the mercy of Dadami Buddhyo. Again, Krishna makes it happen. When you walk on the street, you are not conscious many times, but there is a sound coming from the horn, the vehicle horn. Immediately you move towards left. It is not your plan, okay, there is a vehicle coming, I have to move. You don't plan all these things. Many things are happening just by the arrangement of Krishna. So to say that our every movement, every minute, every second is depending on the arrangement by Supreme Lord in different ways. So how can we say that we are independent? How that false ego can predominantly take our, take our mind from being submissive? So more we appreciate that we are dependent on the mercy of the Lord in different forms and different varieties, then our journey towards spiritual life is steady, and we start appreciating what we are getting. More we appreciate, more we become grateful, because we need to be grateful for everything and anything whatever is given to us. Appreciation leads to gratefulness. If you are grateful, then you'll start feeling humble, because nothing coming out of me, it is a mercy of somebody. We are gratefully acknowledge it. Then more you become humble, probably your surrender process can be more easier also. So all the endeavor, the books, the association of devotees, worship of the deities, offering obeisances, whatever service do, it should help us to become in a prayerful mood, like what are prayers offered by various great souls. The prayer is only one thing: make me humble, let me not even for a fraction of second forget that I am very insignificant, so protect me from the falling down. Like this type of prayers comes out of more we are able to internalize ourselves. The association of devotees helps a lot. In the association, if we start discussing the specialities, the special privilege what we got to be part of this institution. I was reading somewhere, the 50th year's Golden Jubilee celebrations, ISKCON, there are a lot of glories of ISKCON have been brought out, where one of the very interesting thing is, there is only 1 lakh initiated devotees so far. In the 50 years of ISKCON, only 1 lakh initiated devotees. Somehow, who all are initiated, we should feel that some special privilege we have been given already to be a part of the initiated family, and few lakhs of people only seriously practice Krishna consciousness throughout the world. I'm not talking about India alone, throughout the world. Already such a wonderful and unlimited, unqualified mercy we have got without any of our qualification. So let us preserve it, protect it, and be grateful to that, and try to give it to others. Try to make others also to get connected to the mercy. Then our purpose of putting these garments, putting tilak, kanti, everything is useful. We may be externally behaving many things, but unless it goes, it comes from deep into our heart, into our actions, it will be struggle. Benefit always is there, but how much we want to make progress, how we'll take it seriously, makes all possible. That's why Prabhupada, so this, I mean, whenever you read any Prabhupada purport, you can, so much things comes out of it. Today's purport really, you can repeatedly talk about this hundreds of thousands of times. All these are really for us to apply in our day-to-day life. As Venli says, as long as you are in the material modes of nature, nobody can feel themselves they are safe. There is a story I heard, there is in a village, medium type village, there is a very saintly person. He throughout the day, he is absorbed in his sadhana, he is absorption in Krishna's water with him, and during every day evening, he used to sit in a particular place. So villagers used to come, he'll talk something about useful to them about Krishna consciousness, give them that God realization, some slowly help them. So there was a prostitute in that particular village, and she had a daughter, small daughter. The daughter had the hobby of taking, you know, rearing goats and sheep and all. She used to go to forest every day. So during that time, she used to come to this sadhu. And sadhu also had a small beard, and the goat also had beard. So she used to criticize the sadhu. Sadhuji, you tell me whether your beard is nice or my beard of my goat is nice. She used to come daily, she asked this question to him. So sadhu did not answer. He used to make her to go away. After long years, when the sadhu was about to depart from this material world, a very exalted soul, final stages came. He knew that he has become free from all the material contamination. He has become pure, ready to go to spiritual world. So he was fully satisfied, convinced, because the inner made it so happy. Then a lot of people were playing kirtan, everything around him. Then that sadhu called his assistant, somebody, go and get that girl, that girl who used to come every day asking for these courses to me. So they were surprised. Such a, we are having so many people are here giving a lot of lectures, I mean, Kirtan and all. Why is thinking about the particular girl now? Anyhow, they brought her. So the sadhu said, I mean, talking to the girl, he said, then he gave some, rebukement to that girl, and he said, my beard is millions and million times greater than your goat beard. So then people asked, you could have told long back, why you waited so long to tell this particular one single statement? He said, today is the day, now is the time I can say that I am totally out of the contamination of material nature. Though I was practicing, till such time I am about to leave this place, till I am sure that I am going to make the Godhead, I could not utter that, because even if, as long as I would continue here, for a fraction of a second also become inattentive, I become little arrogant, because even by telling a word arrogant, it may make me fall down. Today I am convinced. So that is the instruction, that as long as we are under the material merits of material nature, there is never a fraction of a second where we can say that we are free. So let us all pray to Srila Prabhupada, all the Vaishnavas, all the lordships, to always make us to remember that we are insignificant, so that we can try to absorb, try to adopt and try to use all the instruction given by Prabhupada in our sadhana and make a steady progress, by which we are benefited, we can benefit others also. Thank you very much for your patient hearing. If any corrections, comments, criticism, kindly you can offer. If there any questions, please kindly. Grandhara Srimad Bhagavatam ki jai, Jagat Guru Sri Prabhupada ki jai.